Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Kurt, and welcome back to Assetto Corsa, the driving simulator. I am back with my racing wheel, and I'm back in a Lotus Exige, the new one they added. I featured in the previous video, but they also added, along with these things, some more of the quick race challenges, kind of pre-assigned and assembled race challenges. I did them when they first were added to the game. Of course, now you can make your quick race customizable however many cars or what cars at what track, and it really doesn't matter, but these are some pre-made challenges. This one is called the Lotus Cup, I think. I've already forgotten, but yeah, you basically are set up in this Lotus. You have 11 opponents in assorted other loti, and we are at Imola, the track we almost killed ourselves at on the last video with the F1 car. But we're going to try this out, and as requested, I'm going to try it out with the full manual transmission, the clutch, the 6-speed shifter that I have with the G27 here. So what I've done, the only thing I've changed is the difficulty. I've made the lowest possible 80%, because I'm obviously going to have problems, and I think this should work, because if I remember correctly, this Lotus is not a flappy paddle Lotus. This is a one with a gear lever on the floor. I'm going to take some of your kinder and less insulting suggestions from the video I attempted to learn manual transmission to heart. I have enabled the automatic throttle blip, which is the heel and toe thingamajig when you downshift I had problems with. I'm just not used to doing that. I'm not able to do that. I am not wearing shoes, and the heel, the side of my foot that I would use to kind of blip the throttle is soft and mushy and quite tender, and I think it's probably best to do that with shoes on. But I am going to attempt the clutch, the shift thingy-mabob, so hopefully this works out. I'm racing against other cars, but I'm sure I'm going to have problems and we're never going to see them again. But without further ado, let's get started. Yeah, this thing is a regular manual, right? All right, let's hold the clutch down. I'm sure we can wait. I could probably pop it in the first, am I right? I don't know how to, like, do a start with a clutch. I'm assuming you just pop the clutch out, right? Yeah, you do! Alright. Alright. I'm shifting, everybody! Look, Ma! Oops. Well, I kinda... Oops. Okay, well, yep, I'm... See? This is all confusing. I should turn on the racing light is what I should do, right? Okay, alright. Well, that wasn't as messy as I thought it would be. One of the problems, and a lot of you recognize this, is that normally when I'm racing games with the steering wheel, why is it so bright? Oh, I brake with my left foot and use the gas with my right foot. Obviously, I don't do that in real life, but it's just a lot easier to do in racing games because you have a little bit more fine-tuned control. And I feel like there's a turn coming up here that I don't know about. Yep, here it is. Oh. This is a terrible example of racing skills. Whoopsie, I screwed something up there. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay. And what do I do? There we go. Oh, God. Whoops, forgot to turn. Yeah, I don't think we're really going to be racing anybody. And everybody, I keep hearing even in the other videos and things, oh, it's you'll be much quicker. Obviously not. Oh. You'll be much quicker if you choose a manual transmission. That's why most race cars are manual transmissions. True. true, and if I was, you know, doing this seriously and actually trying to be a good driver, a race car driver. Oh, I should be in second, I think. There we go. And actually perform well, I would probably do that. In fact, that's normally what I do before I started doing YouTube. I remember every time I play Gran Turismo, I would play with manual transmission and other racing games and things like that. I would play with manual transmission, but don't forget that my main... Oh, I forgot what gear I was in completely. I was in fifth. That was a weird thing to experience. Hold on. My main goal here is not to be the greatest driver or show you guys my race car skills. It's to be a YouTube commentary guy. And as you can tell, I can't keep a thought straight in my head when I'm also trying to think of what gear I'm in, what gear I need to go towards, and how, what foot needs to be on where, and I can't even construct the sentence I'm trying to say in order to explain how it's difficult. Oh, I forgot to use the clutch there. There we go. How it's difficult to say sentences while using manual transmission. So that's why in Formula One, in this, and in every other racing game I'm going to play for the YouTube channel, I will not be using manual transmission. There are channels out there I've seen of very, very skilled sim racing people who really know their stuff. They have the full $1,000 racing seat setup and three monitors surrounding them, and they upload videos of them doing amazing feats of heel and toe action and skills and all that fun stuff, but you'll note that they are silent whilst recording these videos. They do not commentate. So, by all means, check out those videos. Whoa, crap on a cracker. Okay, I messed that up. Hold on. Okay, alright. Get things under control, Kurtz. I don't know why it's so bright out. Is it because it's like a... the interior of this car is black? There's like a weird HDR option in the video options that was just enabled by default that I think kind of deals with the fact that it kind of adjusts the exposure of the outside world depending. Okay, all right. Let's get out of the gravel. We're gonna get lapped. That'll be exciting. But yeah, I don't know why it's so bright all of a sudden. I have the transition from second to third. I did get a tip that indeed it is spring-loaded. Whoa, see, I'd mess something up there. Ooh. It's spring-loaded, so when going from second up and to the right and then up to third, I actually don't have to do the right. I don't have to really force it to the right. Oh, speaking of forcing things into gears, I don't have to force it to the right. The spring actually brings it into the position, so I really have to push up, kind of let go, and then push up again. Of course, as we saw in the previous first lap, going from fifth is a little bit of a question for me. Oh man, in this game, this racing wheel, woo! Alright, well, I missed that shift, so that was kind of pointless, but... Oh, see, and my left foot still wants to use that as the brake. It's a very, Oh, I almost missed fourth. I've messed up. The chicanes surprise me every time. It's something I need to train my brain not to do, because obviously with F1, I race with my left and right foot. Oh, see? Fifth to fourth is a tough one. I've got to somehow tell myself to do the same thing as going second to third, but the opposite. But my brains cannot. Oh, yeah. Even that was a little bit weird to try to figure out. Let's go to sixth just to see what happens. Not much. There's not too much of a. Whoops. Okay, I'm in fourth now. That's probably not where I want to be. All right, third. Let's stick with third. Ha. Why is it so bright? Should be a sunglasses mod. See, I lifted off the brake when I was shifting. That's not really necessary, Kurt. It's complicated. Give me a break. Oh, that's fourth. That's second. And now I've come to a complete stop anyway, so I guess I should be in first. All right, turning. I will finish this race if it kills me. And as usual, all of the comments about, oh, you lazy American, not knowing how to drive a manual transmission. Well, we just like to embrace technologies that were invented 60 years ago. Whoops. That is the automatic transmission to make our lives a little bit more simpler. Excuse me! whoops. Alright, well that's... I just have to get my shifting done, like downshifting done, prior to getting to the turn, it seems. Probably the best way to go about that. At least I'm not getting lapped. Okay, I'm not gonna shift into fifth because that just screws me up royally. Whoops. Oh god, what have I done? Let's go back to fourth. Let's just try that out. Okay, there we go. Alright. Fourth to fifth. It's a tricky little bugger. Okay, that didn't work at all. commentary! It's fun being this active in the shifting. Yeah, the whole getting your shifting done before the turn is kind of the way to go, I think. Probably not the way to go, but for me, for somebody learning, it's the way to go. Okay, now I don't have to worry about shifting anymore. I can take the turn through what was possibly the most incorrect line possible. And then continue on. Whoa, getting some strange force feedback there. Alright, brake. Shift. Oh, I probably... Probably could have gone into third through that turn. That's another thing. You really have to know the track and the speeds and the car and which gear you can really take through a turn. And I know nothing... Oh my god, I know nothing of the sort. Alright, yep. Nothing of the sort. Alright, here's the chicane coming up that screws me up. I will start breaking. Use the rumblies to your advantage. And there we go. Huzzah! And I think I am gonna finish without getting lapped here. Oh, I'm gonna screw this up though, that's for sure. Oh, how about that one? There we go! Hunt for the correct, the hunt for the Red October, the hunt for the proper gear change. There we go. And I don't know where the finish line is, but be in fifth for it. Session over. Ah, it really hurts my legs too. Whew. Whew. Ho, brother. That was a disaster of the highest proportions. I was 86 seconds behind. Shh. Don't tell anybody. Yeah, I don't know that there's going to be too much interesting in the replay. Other than a guy who's just going off the track. And whoops, what's he doing? I don't know. I think he's eating a sandwich or something at the same time he's trying to drive. Look at him, what's wrong with him? Oh man, that's terrible. And the sound's terrible as well. Yes, all right. Then here's the turn where I could go into fifth, but I simply don't have time to comprehend how to. It looks okay, as long as you don't pay attention to the fact that I'm doing that sort of stuff. Oh, it's a terrible thing. All right, let me, I don't know, maybe I'll try something different, but with a car with flappy paddles to see if that's any of a different experience. Of course, all the flappy paddle cars are like the super crazy, insane cars that I can't even wrap my head around driving with automatic transmissions, but we will see. We will see, indeed, in a moment. Be right back. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and before I try out the flappy paddle gearbox, I wanted to show you guys one part of the game that I have never showed you, and that is the drag race. And I figured, since I'm trying to use the manual transmission here, that maybe it would be a good chance to... I feel like I got a good start on the last one. I've got the whole let go of the clutch thing down in first gear. So maybe a drag race is in order. I'm still getting this weird, like, really high resolution. Like, the brights are, like, radioactive, and it's a little bit annoying. I don't know what option I changed, or maybe they changed in the last update that really threw that off. But hopefully it fixes itself when I get in the car. I'm not exactly sure how this works. I chose to go up against a Fiat, and I'm here in a BMW, so... Sorry. Okay, oh, I see, we gotta watch the... Go! We gotta win this, our car is better. This is a 1 kilometer drag race. Are we winning? I think we're winning, I see him in the rearview mirror. We're doing better than you. In a car that is better than yours. Was that it? That was it, right? Yeah, okay. I don't want to be the dude stopping before the race is actually over. Very interesting. Yeah, I don't see how much more action you can get in a drag race. I mean, I suppose maybe with the advent of multiplayer, and maybe with the ability to customize your car or unlock certain cars or something, you might be able to go head to head with a friend or something like that and have drag races and things like that. But I'm just not sure the overall feasibility of this as a game mode. But it's something even Oops, oh, I totally missed the start there. Ooh, Whoop, I missed that gear as well. Although I think I just chose a car that is much better than his. I am a cheater, my friends. I am a cheater. Oop, keep going straight, though. That is kind of essential in a drag race. Oh, this is weird. Like, barely enough time to go into fifth, but I don't think that would be worth it. All right, so this is a drag racing. Maybe I should go back and attempt to, like, choose the same car. And maybe I'll do that. All right, so I'll be right back. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm back, and you might have thought that I would give the other guy the BMW, but no, I have gone down and I have chosen the Fiat Abarth. I don't know why I always flip the R and the B, but we're going to give this a shot. The slowest car in the game, and we're going to take it for a 1 kilometer drag race. And I have a feeling that my shift points are going to be all the more essential. Oh, that is different. How am I doing? Am I doing okay? I can't tell. Alright. Oh, he's catching! He's gaining! Speed! Power! Go! Go! Ah! This is a close one. Oh, I screwed it up. I see that fourth to fifth. There is like a little bit of a lip there. Fourth to fifth. Fourth to fifth. All right, I'll have to get used to that. All right, so he won that one. You win this round, Orange Fiat. I will win the next one. All right, get my... Oh, sorry. I accidentally let go of the clutch. Bog down the engine. All right. I should probably try to minimize the amount of wheel spin I have as well. Go, 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 go! No! Dang it! I'm getting too flustered! Yeah, he's going away. Bye! I wonder what happens if I just ran him off the road. Whoa, I am going to start to do that if I continue veering to the right. 29.9. Pop the parachute! It's the only kind of... Oh, I almost started driving. It's the only type of drag racing I know about. All right. One more try. I'm getting very terrible starts. Oh, I almost jumped the gun there. All right. And... Oh, dang it. The wheel spin confused me. I thought I was supposed to shift. Yeah, he's got a little bit of an edge on me. That was kind of a short shift. I don't know if that was, No, that was terrible. I'm a terrible human being. Oh, that was okay. Fourth into fifth. I'm learning that, but again... God, that whole ordeal? The whole ordeal. I only got 6/10 of a second faster or something like that. Craziness. All right, seriously, one more time. I screwed up too much there. Things must change. I must perfect the art of drag racing against tiny, tiny, tiny cars. It's the start that screws me up. The first gear on this car is really short. I feel like that was weird, too. Okay. I feel like we synchronized our shifts there, so I feel like I'm doing okay. Yes! Just pay attention. Keep going straight. I don't think he shifted yet. No, he didn't. Now he just shifted. No! No! Ah! 29.1. I don't think I'm ever going to break 29. Seconds. So there we go. This has been yet another futile exercise in using a manual transmission and clutch and whatnot in Assetto Corsa. Not that much is going to keep happening again here. Oh, I see. These are my times. My first time was 110, 102. Wait, what? No, that's not right. I'm confused. What? Oh, those are the... What? I have no idea what these numbers mean, honestly. It's a very confusing thing, racing. A very confusing thing indeed. How do I go... Alright, yeah, go away. There's no, like, replay function. I don't know how many rounds it gives me, but obviously they won. Obviously. I was gonna do, like, a replay. I hope maybe there's not a replay. It's just two cars driving in a straight line. I will describe it for you. But yeah, I don't think I have time to do another flappy paddle thing, so perhaps in a future video. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Kurt. I will see you next time. One more. You're going down, son. Orange tomato. Who are you? You look like a guy from the Star Wars universe. Doesn't he? That guy in the orange and the helmet? Looks like he should be working on the Death Star. Alright, when does he start revving? Now, and... Oh, I bogged down! Dang it! Screw you! Whoa!